Hello students, welcome back again. Myself Adil Hussain Sheikh, Assistant Professor, Automobile Department, LGIT, and welcome back to the lecture series of ACET. Okay, as we had already discussion regarding turbocharged system in our previous lectures, so in today we are going to discuss about some various exhaust divided systems as well as challenges and which are the advantages of turbocharged system in our particular IC engine systems. As we had a discussion regarding, first one is introduction session. Second thing is that historical background of turbocharged and supercharged systems, as well as we had a discussion regarding problems and challenges associated with turbocharged systems in particularly SI engines with direct injection systems, and we had already discussion regarding so many things in problems like mechanical loading, thermal loading, turbo lag, as well as knock and abnormal combustions and so on. Okay. Today we are going to discuss about some basic exhaust divided systems as well as advantages of turbocharged in SI engines, and we are also going to discuss challenges of turbocharged systems in SI engines. So today we are going to discuss about divided exhaust period systems for turbocharged engines. As you can see in figure, there is a one turbocharged system, and turbocharged system connected with divided valves. Okay, you can see basically there are two types of valve, valve A and valve B. See, valve A means exhaust blowdown to turbine, and second thing is valve B means scavenging of valve systems. Okay, what is the meaning of scavenging? As we know about in particularly in four stroke IC engines, pistons work as a pump and it help to reduce eliminate scavenging effect in particularly four stroke SI engines, right? To valve B working as a scavenging valve, it guided the exhaust coming out from the engines and directed towards to the catalytic converters. And most important thing in particular system is the valve A. Valve A is direct exhaust towards the turbine systems, and with the help of this turbine system, with the help of this exhaust system, we can run the turbine effectively and we can use properly exhaust in this particular way. So we can say that it's with the help of this system we can reduce or eliminate the exhaust losses, as well as main important things in particularly exhaust system, we can say that there is a back pressure system, right? Back pressure phenomenon. And there are lots of disadvantages of back pressure phenomenon in SI engines as well as CI engines. So in this particular system with divided exhaust system, we can eliminate back pressures, reduce back pressure losses, as well as we can also reduce the back pressure system with proper divided flow of exhaust. Okay, and with the help of this particular system, we can also bifurcate the upcoming exhaust with the help of necessary devices, and we can also reduce the emission from the upcoming engines, and we can achieve emission standards with our requirements with the help of this system. You can see in figure there is a one valve A and valve B. Valve A is connected directly turbine, and in dotted line you can see valve B. Valve B is directly connected with the select starter catalyst. Which type of catalyst we are using nowadays? Mainly we are using three-way catalytic converter, and mainly platinum, palladium and rhodium we are using nowadays in our turbocharged systems, as well as our exhaust emission system. We are also use selective catalyst reductions and lean NOx trap in our SI engines emission system. With the help of these systems, we can eliminate some hazardous particles coming out from the engine. So this is the main most important features of turbocharged systems. We can say that divided exhaust period system for turbocharged engines. Okay, now further we are going to discuss about emissions. Okay, see, emission is the main problem from the all engines, like SI engines, CI engines, or we can say that hybrid engines also, right? And mostly effect of charging may be positive or may be negative on the systems. Like in terms of positive, we can say that it can eliminate upcoming exhaust. Okay, and also we can say that it may be reduced some hazardous exhaust particles coming out from the engines, and negative effect, we can say that it can increase the back pressure of the systems, or we can say that it also decrease the life of the particular engine. Okay, so maybe effect of the charging in terms of positive, we also can say that, or in terms of negative, we can say that, right? See, in turbocharged system, we can say that all the particles running at very high RPMs as well as very high temperature and pressure. So at that time, effect of charging in emission systems, we have to consider, right? And while considering this charging system, we have to meet requirements and emissions requirements of emission standards as per the emission norm. So we can say that charging directly effect may be positive or may be negative on upcoming emission or upcoming exhaust from the engine. Okay. Second thing is that volume proportionality work with unburnt hydrocarbons. Okay. There might be a chances of to increase hydrocarbon tendency in upcoming exhaust or in combustion chambers, right? So with the help of this charging system, we can increase it or we can decrease it also. So we have to be careful while deciding these types of charging systems. Third one is the effect of NOx on NOx limit, right? See, basically NOx limit directly concerned with the compression ratios and effect efficiency of the internal combustion engines in terms of indicated power, right? See, whenever we are implement charging systems, it directly increase the compression ratio, and while increase the compression ratio, there might be a chances of increased knocking tendency in combustion chamber. So this knocking tendency increase the NOx value from the upcoming exhaust. So we have to design properly turbocharged system to decrease the knocking tendency. Last one is the thermal inertia of exhaust manifold. Okay. See, upcoming exhaust charge have pressure and temperature range, and indirectly relate with the exhaust manifold boundaries, right? And while considering these types of phenomenon, we have to take care about exhaust manifold material, exhaust manifold design, as well as temperature and pressure fatigue on exhaust manifold system. So we have to consider thermal inertia also while designing exhaust manifold and emission systems, right? Let us discuss the advantages of the turbocharged system in SI engine. First one is the main and most important things nowadays we are going to consider in our purchasing value: less fuel consumption. Okay, see, we all have one basic requirement like less fuel consumption, right? And turbocharged have significantly give this kind of output with the use of this proper charging system. Second and most important thing is that throttle loss improvement. Okay, see, if you have throttle less, then we can feel acceleration, we can feel less acceleration compared to required acceleration, right? So with the help of this charging system, we can eliminate throttle loss improvements. Okay, and with the help of this proper charging system, we can also increase the pressure in our combustion chambers. Okay. Most important things, NOx control with lean operation management. We have already know that turbocharged system operate on very lean system. Okay, and with the help of this lean system, we can reduce the NOx particle. But most important thing is when we are going to eliminate this NOx particles in terms of unburned hydrocarbons, we can say that unhydrocarbon efficiency or unhydrocarbons particles increasing significantly while reducing the NOx emissions. Okay, so this is directly effect of turbocharging in SI engines. And nowadays we are using second generation engines, right? And we had already discussed regarding second generation engines like wall guided systems, spray guided systems. So with the help of this wall guided and spray guided system, we can get extra pressure range in our SI engines, and with the help of this extra pressure range, we can get a more power compared to naturally aspirated engine. So this is the main advantages of the turbocharged systems in SI engines. Okay. So let us discuss which are the challenges in turbocharged system. We had already discussed so many problems regarding it. So let us discuss first one is the control of air fuel ratio. We have to maintain air fuel ratio as per the requirement of the engines and as per the output of the turbocharged system. Otherwise, there might be a turbo leak or there might be a misfiring system in our particular engine. Second thing is the specific fuel consumption. Okay, see, whenever we are using naturally aspirated engines or turbocharged engines, we have to maintain the level of fuel consumption, right? If it is increased, then there might be a loss of fuel efficiency, okay, or we can say that high specific fuel consumption, right? So, compare with naturally aspirated engines of turbocharged system, we have to maintain level of the fuel system, like we have to calibrate all fuel injection system like fuel pump, feed pumps, as well as secondary fuel pump, and we have to maintain also pressure level in this particular system. Third one is the exhaust emissions requirement. Right now we have a BS6 standards, before few years ago we have BS4 standards. So accordingly requirements of the standards, we have to follow emission norms, right? As per the as we are going to compare our naturally aspirated engines with turbocharged systems, we have to maintain emission level coming out from the engines. And most important thing is the boost pressure control. Like, if we did not control boost pressure, so it directly leads to abnormal combustion and knocking. And as we know that abnormal combustion and knocking will going to be reduced engine efficiency, right? So we have to consider boost pressure control while designing this type of turbocharged systems. And most important thing is the rotation of the turbocharger, right? With the help of exhaust, we are going to run our turbine system, right? So we have to calculate all the necessary data to run this turbocharged system. Okay, so while designing turbine system in turbocharged, we have to consider exhaust pressure and temperature and exhaust flow also, right? So rotation of turbocharger is most important thing in SI engines of turbocharged system. So these are the main challenges nowadays associated with turbocharged systems in SI engines compared to CI engines. Okay, right, control air fuel ratio, specific fuel consumption, same level exhaust emissions, as well as boost pressure control and rotation of turbocharger. So this is it from the chapter number 3 of turbocharged systems in SI engines. In very next chapter, we are going to discuss about stratified charge injection systems in SI engines. Till date, stay home and thank you.